Amanda. What's up, Galore Gang? It's your girl, Amanda Galore, and we're back again with another video. You know what I'm saying? Today, we did a little soft little, you know, a little soft little cute little. So I did a thing on Instagram and I was like, hey, let me know what look you guys want to see with the red hair. And a lot of people were like, a soft, natural look. So I was like, okay, let's do something soft, but I'm not going to be too natural because it's like, that's just not me. I wouldn't do too natural, like, especially with red, I'm going to be feeling myself. So I would probably do a natural, but like a little, So we came up with this look. It's a soft little beat. We just really added some, a little definition to the eyes. And, oh, hold up. Let's look at a little. Okay, so we just added a little bit of definition to the eyes, and that's about really it. That's the only thing I took away from the whole natural look. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy. Don't forget to go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe. If you are not subscribed, honey, what are you doing? Like, really, what are you doing? Because you know the girl lit, so you might as well subscribe. It's right there, right there. Like, just look down a little bit. Don't go too far down, but just come up a little bit. It's like midsection right here. I'll say subscribe. Go ahead and click that. Just click it. Just click it. It's not gonna hurt. It takes 2 seconds. If you want to, you could do that. Just that going up. Don't forget to follow me on IG at Amanda_Galore. I post everything on there. Like, literally, my life is on there. So, might as well follow your girl. You know what I'm saying? You might as well just follow me. Might as well just follow me. Might as well not. But I hope you guys enjoy. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for watching. Okay, so now we're going to be using the Hangover by Too Faced. This primer is very good for me. I have huge pores and texturized skin. So I just put it all over my face. I mainly focus on my problem areas, as you'll see throughout this video. Okay, so now we're going to be using Fit Me 30 and 40 just to set in that primer that we put. Typically, you would use your foundation color, but it just wasn't coming out that way. But that's fine. Any loose powder that you have to set in that primer will work. Okay, so now we're using a sample size for the NARS Natural Radiant in the color Macho, I believe it is. And I'm mixing it with my Fenty foundation in the color 440. The NARS one is just a little too hydrating for me. I have oily skin and I just didn't like how it was with by itself. But then the Fenty is a little too high, is a little too mattifying for me. So I tried to mix both of them. It was a fail on my end. I don't really like how it came out, but we'll see. So I still wasn't feeling my foundation color, so I went ahead and added more Fenty in the 440. The NARS foundation is a very overpowering foundation. I did not know that.
Next time I would suggest to do more Fenty and add a little bit of NARS just to give it, just to soften up how mattifying the Fenty foundation is, because NARS is really strong. The Fenty still wasn't matching to the NARS foundation. So that's what I would suggest to do. Okay, so now I'm going in with the best concealer in the world, the Fenty in color 385. I love this concealer. I don't think I would ever find another concealer to do me how this concealer does me. It's literally bomb. Okay, so I'm gonna add a half wing because literally I'm taking this makeup right off and I wasn't going anywhere. So I just did the corner wing, the outer wing, just to give it an illusion of a wing, but I did not do a whole wing. I didn't even put any eyeshadow on for this look. I just wanted to give it some definition. I just wanted to give it a little oomph that I needed because I do have on individuals and I just didn't need much. I just wanted to put something extra. Okay, so I got another sample of a NARS concealer. I would really recommend getting samples of products before you buy them because I've heard so much good things about NARS, and my first impressions with NARS is a no for me. It is too hydrating. My skin will eat it up like concealer wear. But I needed something to lift up my face a little bit without being too highlighting, so I had to use it. But NARS just has too much of an orange undertone for me. My undertone is golden, but theirs is a strong, it's orange more so. I wasn't feeling it. I probably need to test drive some other ones, but I would definitely say get some samples before you buy the full product because it was a no for me. Okay, so now I'm using the Black Radiance foundation stick in the color Espresso as my contour. I love this color for my contour. Like, I love it. You can make it dark, you can make it very sharp, and it can also be very light. I love this color. Okay, now we're going in with the Sasha Buttercup Setting Powder. This powder is bomb if you want a very natural face. You don't want a highlighted look. You want just a simple, flawless, skin-like look. This is the go-to. So I have really bad smile crease lines, whatever you want to call them. Within about 30 minutes, mines will start creasing up. So I just put powder there. I let it sit there and make sure my face does not move, especially when I'm laughing, smiling, etc. It would just start creasing up. So I use the same Fit Me Deep 40 to set my contour. It lightens it up a little bit. If you want it darker, I would suggest to use a darker powder. This powder isn't the darkest. It's the darkest in their collection, but it's not the darkest. I like that it lightens it up. I don't like my contour too dark. So that's what I use, but it's a good setting powder. But as I said, if you do want something darker, if you do want it stronger, I wouldn't suggest this powder. Okay, and now I'm going to take the complete blending brush in the e.l.f. collection, and I'm going to blend out my whole face. And when I'm blending out my whole face, then I will go ahead and blend in that excess powder that is around my smile crease. Now for the thing that I hate. I am going to cut my contour. I literally hate a cut contour. I don't know why I've been doing it so much. I think I just like the neat look of it, but I hate a cut contour. I hate it with a passion. And I don't know, I think my face is lopsided because one side is always cut different than the other. I really hate it. I don't know why I do it so much, but whatever. We're gonna go ahead and cut it. I'm using the same Buttercup powder just to cut it because it's a softer finish. And it's easier to blend back in my face so I don't have that line there. I literally hate that. Okay, I don't know what happened to it showing me blending it out, but I just took a powder brush and blended it until my skin looked back flawless. Now I am taking the Chestnut lip liner by MAC, and I'm going to line my lip. Now I'm using the Kiss Eyebrow Gel in the color Espresso, I believe, and my eyebrows are already shaped, so I didn't have to conceal, which is why I did them kind of last. So I'm just going ahead and filling my eyebrows in and just darkening up the shape that's already there. Okay, so you guys are legit gonna hate me for this lip combo because I do not have the name for any of these. This is a Kiss liquid lipstick. It is the pinkest shade they have. It looks like bubblegum, so anything that's pink like that, you'll get that. And then I top coat it with a pastel nude type of pink. It's not a light pink though, it's kind of like a dark nude pink. I wish I had the color for you, but I don't. So I topped it with that and it came. That's how I got my lip combo. Thank you. So now I'm going in with some black eyeshadow. My individuals were bold. My liner is bold, so I needed something bold underneath the eye. The mascara alone wasn't doing it for me, so I just needed to intensify my under eye. Okay, so my face was missing something. It just wasn't working. So I decided to go in and use a translucent powder just to give me a more highlighted effect without actually highlighting. And it did absolute justice. Okay, so now that I feel good about my complete face, I'm gonna go ahead and go in with some blush. It is a ruby pink, so it's not a pastel pink. It's more so of a dark tone pink, just to give me some color, just to mesh everything in with my lips. Okay, so because I'm doing a more neutral, natural look, I used the Black Radiant Light to Medium Contour Palette rather than the medium to dark one, just because the highlight in there is a softer highlight. And then I just took a regular gold eyeshadow and put it in my teardrop just to brighten up my eyes a little bit. Okay, so now to finish up the look, I went ahead and used the MAC Neutral Lip Gloss. I hate lip gloss, but I decided to go with more of a Barbie look. I prefer matte, but it'll work, whatever. I could learn a lot from you, gotta come teach me. You a little hot girl, you a little sweetie. Sweet like Palin, sweet like...